Match game 74, production number 0257, take one. Get ready to match the star. McLean Stevenson. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Riley. Joni Summer. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded big money match game 74. And now here's the star of match game 74, Gene Raver.
R. Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends. Everybody ready?
Everybody ready.
Are you all crazy as ever?
Absolutely.
Not as crazy as that jacket, but we're fine. Not as crazy as that jacket, but we're fine.
One of my conservative numbers. I'm taking my cue here from Sir Richard.
Very nice.
Thank you very much.
But he's on his way to a bar mitzvah.
Would you greet our two players here, Paul Rodkin and Louis Ping Canole?
Paul is our current champ. He's won $600. He's got one game under his belt, and he's happy about that. Are you still up for grabs?
Yes.
Are you gainfully employed?
Well, I'm in business for myself.
Oh, are you gainfully employed, is the question. And Louis is challenging him. We've played her half of round one, and his half is coming up in a moment or so. She scored three times with her question. We'll see how he does right after we see how you do with this message. Here we go. Push the button. Reveal a question for Paul Rodkin. 3-0, and let's see how you do with yours. The cannibal said, I just had a terrific Italian dinner. I ate blank cacciatore. The cannibal said, I just had a terrific Italian dinner. I ate blank cacciatore. I like this question.
The first one I've liked all week. I'm going to mug that guy who wrote those others in the parking lot.
Well, we don't identify the writers. We keep that a secret.
Well, you shouldn't.
They were nominated for an Emmy.
Well,
Charles.
I have no comment.
You go to an Italian restaurant here all the time. You ought to know blank cacciatore, don't you? Okay, here we go.
Si.
All right, Paul. The cannibal said, I just had a terrific Italian dinner. I ate blank cacciatore.
Missionary.
I ate missionary cacciatore. Very good, huh? Do you think it's a good answer, but he's not going to win with it? Wait till you hear from the dingbats over here. All right, dingbat number one.
Okay, dingbat number one, who does have to hurry right after the show because I'm going to a Pizza Palace opening with Cesar Romero. That's why I wore the white coat. What do you think? I said Joe.
Joe Cacciatore. Joe Cacciatore.
Well, yeah.
Okay. I had the same idea, but not a match. Brett?
Don't worry about him. He's going to be fine.
Yes, he is.
That poor little devil, no wonder he isn't gainfully employed. I said missionary cacciatore.
Missionary cacciatore, Charles.
Well, I said godfather cacciatore because you kept saying Italian.
Oh, all right.
Put that in your popcorn.
I said man cacciatore. Is that close?
Man, right? No match there, sorry to say. Let's see if we have match up here with Richard Dawson.
Yeah, missionaries, you see, wouldn't necessarily be Italian. You do understand that, Paul?
Yes.
Missionario.
Just cross yourself once for yes or twice for no.
The godfather's Italian.
Would you like to do a little dissertation?
I'd like to go home.
You want to go home? Why?
I really do, because I'm just off my feed.
Oh.
I really am.
Oh.
I don't know what got into me.
Grandmother?
Maybe you can explain to me why I wrote Grandmother. If
Grandmother?
Anyone could explain it to me, I'd be most happy to.
Especially since she was a tough old bird anyway. Okay, so it's 3-1 at this moment. We'll go to round two and ask Louis to make a selection here.
I'll take B again.
B is what she wants, and this is what we've got for her. This time...
There's a thing flashing here. It says, don't write.
You don't write, because you matched Louis in the first round. And so did Richard, and so did Joni. The others will participate in this. The blacksmith believes in being prepared. He always keeps a blank in his pants.
The blacksmith believes. Do you have blacksmiths in?
Yep.
There you do.
Yeah.
Okay, well, you know what I'm talking about then. Blacksmith believes in being prepared. He always keeps a blank in his pants.
Don't you love the way Brett grades our papers?
Yes.
She just got through saying to me, this is going to be on the midterm, so you better get it right.
All right, they're all set over there. We'll get a response from Louie right now. The blacksmith believes in being prepared. He always keeps a blank in his pants.
Hammer.
A hammer. She said a hammer in his pants.
Well, sure, she did.
Yeah, that's what she said.
She said a hammer. Said. She said a hammer in his pants. I said a shoe in his pants.
A shoe, yeah. Right. Horseshoe. That would be a good answer.
And I'm trying.
Charles, no, horseshoe is a good answer.
That's two shoes.
Yeah, horseshoe would seem to be the answer.
That's a pair.
Yes. And.
I'm
you contribute
real
a horseshoe, a hammer, a nail, or what? Anything.
I'm real off my feed, and I'd like to embarrass myself further. I said the horseshoe.
The horseshoe. Yeah. Everybody said horseshoe. Now, that was a good answer there.
Hammer's an
excellent
answer.
So you didn't do any very well with that, Louis. Let's see how you do with yours. But first, we've got to do a little business with America. This is it. Here we go. Question for you. 3-0. You've got to score 2 times to stay in the game. 3 matches will win another game for you. This is it. Brett, you do not participate.
Do you think I'm getting smarter or the contestants are getting dumber? That's twice that I have
That's
not.
That's right. You've been matching older, in the first round. Brett. Getting older, then.
And better.
The old sailor said to the new sailor, since this is your first time at sea, I'll give you some advice. Never blank into the wind. The old sailor.
I know what the question is. I'm just trying to find out if you can say that on TV. Make Brett go away.
Brett, would you leave him alone? This is it. I'll leave him.
Trying to help him. Doesn't he look like he's on his way to a dance at the country club in Toledo, Ohio? What did you say?
All right, they're already there, up there. And they're ready down here. Now we're all going to be surprised. Now, Brett, leave him alone. Okay, Paul Rodkin. The old sailor said to the new sailor, since this is your first time at sea, I'll give you some advice. Never blank into the wind.
Tinkle.
Yes?
Can he say that?
I just heard him say it.
Me!
Yeah, get back up there. Meal train.
Christmas.
The well, old sailor, I'll give you some advice. Never blank into the wind. He said tinkle.
Right. Well, I just said spit.
That's the correct answer.
Now, that's without my help.
I know.
Charles?
When I blew his popcorn answer, I said I would never do this to him again. And here's one answer that is not all wet. Tinkle.
There's one for you. You need one more to tie. Joni, we call on you.
Oh, I did a most obvious one. Instead of blow, I said put sail.
Never sail into the wind.
Into the wind.
Can't be done.
No, I know. That's why you shouldn't do it.
Richard?
Try.
Sail into
the
wind.
Very old saying in England is
tried, folks.
Never throw
garbage.
Garbage.
Never throw into garbage the into the wind. All right, you got to match Ann Elder to stay in the game.
Yeah.
The whole weight of this thing is on your shoulders.
I'd like to apologize
again?
For being off my feet. No, I have sailed before, and I understand yeah. about this.
Yeah.
There's an old adage that you never do throw up in the wind.
So Louie wins the game. Congratulations. Come on down. There's $100 for you. You stand by for a moment or so. We have to say goodbye to Paul Rodkin. It was a pleasure meeting you, Paul.
Pleasure being here, Gene.
I'm glad you enjoyed it. You've got you've got how much? $600 to your credit. Thank you very much, Paul Rodkin. Louie here is going to have a go at over $5,000. You've seen this and you know how it goes, right?
Right.
Okay, you ready?
Ready.
All right. All right, there. I just want to get a close look at that. I haven't seen that. That's very pretty. All right. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Fig blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match that one. And if you match the next one, it's $250. And if you match the third, you get $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Fig.
Ah, oh, shh. Shh.
All right, Louis, sick 'em.
Fig Leaf.
Fig Leaf.
I'll take Brett.
You'll take Brett.
I'll say Fig Newton.
All right. Okay, there's two.
And McLean.
McLean.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, what was used so far? I didn't hear what
he said.
You know, you Fig don't
leaf.
Hear anything all week.
And the reason I don't is because you're talking and Brett's eating candy.
It's a lot of...
Fig Leaf and Fig Newton are the two answers we have so
far. In that case, I'm going to take Fig Bar.
Fig Bar. Okay.
Which nobody's ever heard of.
Yeah. All right, so you got Fig Bar, Fig right. Newton, and Fig Leaf. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. Are those familiar to you?
Yeah. I'll take Fig Leaf.
You'll take a Fig Leaf? Well, let's see. What size shall we give her? What size? So Fig Leaf is what she's looking for. And we'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response? Fig Tree. Okay, there's one. And let's see what we've got under the $250 response. Fig Newton. That's the answer Brett gave you. Okay. Here's your third and last chance to get a Fig Leaf. Size 8. Here is the $500 response. Fig Leaf. Means you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. But in order to collect that amount of money, you have to match one celebrity head-to-head. This time, it has to be an exact match, and it's time to choose one now.
Richard.
You choose Richard. All right, you face me. Richard, here's a $5,000 question. Mission blank. Oh. Mission blank. Okay, Richard's finished his answer. What answer do you come up with in order to match his? Mission?
Impossible.
Mission Impossible. Richard, I dare say everyone in the studio audience, if he or she were sitting in your seat, would have written Mission Impossible. I dare say you're going to get lynched if you haven't written Mission Impossible.
Well, I don't agree with that. What about that yo-yo who said Newton?
Yeah.
He probably would have said mission accomplished. But yeah. I didn't. Impossible. Yeah.
So you've got a total of $5,600, and you're going to meet another player a little bit later. But right now, we've got to do a little business and get you a chance to pull yourself together. Okay?
Okay.
All right. See you tomorrow. Now, are you all set, Louie? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. We're ready to play another game. To do that, we are very pleased to present a new player. Here is Evelyn Gibson. How are you, Evelyn?
Hi. Nervous.
Now we will hear the Evelyn Gibson story. What is the Evelyn Gibson story?
Well, I'm single. I live in Encino, California, and I work for Singles Club in Los Angeles.
You do? That must be interesting
she
work.
She runs a singles club?
No, I just work there.
You work there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, it's nice to meet you, Evelyn. Good
Thank
luck
you.
To you. Now, push this button and ask you to make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants, and A is what she gets, folks. Here it is. At the match game Christmas party, everybody kissed Brett when Brett put blank over her head.
I don't have to put up with this. I'm an heiress.
At the match game Christmas party, everybody kissed Brett when Brett put blank over her head. All right. Waiting for Charles. Now we're all set. Evelyn Gibson. At the match game Christmas party, everybody kissed Brett when Brett put blank over her head.
Mistletoe.
Mistletoe is a good answer. That's a good answer, Mistletoe. It
certainly is. And it's one unmarried person who lives in the valley to another. Pretty.
Yeah, yes. You don't live in the valley, though, do you?
No, well, I got a good humor route out there, but I'm... I put down... Mistletoe.
Mistletoe. Okay, that was a good answer, all right, Brett.
I put down lampshade, because that's what actually happened.
Oh, yeah. One or two, and that's it. Okay, Whee! Charles?
I was going to put bag, but that was a terrible answer, and I wouldn't say that because we're very close friends.
And engaged.
That's two for you.
Are you offering a little mistletoe, my dear?
I'd like to help out with mistletoe, but I thought she might have put Richard Dawson over her and the Christmas party. Oh, listen, I tried.
Boost him right up there, eh?
If you're having fun, you can do anything.
Yes. Richard, what do you say?
Maybe you shouldn't drink so early in the day. I put mistletoe.
You get it. Okay, Evelyn. How about the mistletoe?
Well, she hasn't been too well lately.
No, I haven't been well. But somehow my feed came back, and I'm so thrilled I said mistletoe. Oh, yeah.
That's four for you. Now, Louis, here's your first round question. Everybody participates. Roy Rogers said, "This new dog food smells like a dead horse." And Day 11 said, "That's not dog food you're smelling. That's your blank." Roy Rogers said, "This new dog food smells like a dead horse." And Day 11 said, "That's not dog food you're smelling. That's your blank." Richard's the first one finished, because he's the best.
You always say he's the best.
You're the second best, and that's not bad. I mean, second best pays a lot of money.
That's the rumor around town.
All right. Well, Charles, I don't know what we're going to do with you. Okay. Now, Louis, Roy Rogers said, you know who Roy Rogers is?
Yeah.
"This new dog food smells like a dead horse." Day 11 said, "You know who she is."
Mm-hmm.
"Well, they were fooling around together," she said. "That's not dog food you're smelling, that's your blank."
"A dinner."
"Your dinner." Okay. She said dinner.
Dinner. Dinner. Oh, now, Dale is his wife, and Trigger was the horse, right?
Right, right.
I told you. She thought he had Roy. You know what she thought? Dale Roy Rogers was... had Dale stuffed. It's the horse. Dale Evans out in a big glass case in Apple Valley going...
"How do you like to meet my wife, Trigger?"
I said breath.
Her breath. That's not dog food you're smelling, that's your breath. I see. Oh, dear me. All right. Put yourself together.
I'm not wearing any socks either. I've lost my shoe.
Could you take a little time out to play the game?
He's funny sometimes. Yes.
That's not dog food you're smelling, that's your...
Well, I was going to say Trigger, but I couldn't remember his name. So I said, that's your horse.
Okay. Oh, boy. Charles.
These questions are so hard this week.
Breath again.
He said breath, too.
I'm sorry.
Okay, Joni, what did you say?
Well, I forgot the question. I think I'm catching what she had. But I also said horse. And
horse.
I think we're both...
So we got two horses and
both
two breaths.
Horses.
But we have no dinner so far. Richard?
He said dinner horse. I was going to change.
Louie, I think this is the start of a beautiful friendship.
Dinner. That's right. What's that? Off my feed. Speaking of horses.
Yes. Yeah. I said Trigger.
Trigger.
Well, yes, I went
for that. That wasn't such a rotten answer. You looked
yes,
at me.
It was
yes,
rotten,
it was a rotten
right?
answer. Okay, so it's 4-1, and we go to round two and ask Evelyn to make a selection.
I'll pick A again.
A. All right, here we go. This is only for two people, Brett and Joni. Oh. The Martian was a big hit at the party because he used his blank as a corkscrew. The Martian was a big hit at the party because he used his blank
yes,
as a corkscrew.
That's
Let's finish.
Other people distract me that I can't finish quickly.
Right.
I don't know how to write this.
Well, that's a good answer.
Spelling doesn't count.
Spelling doesn't count here as long as we can figure
it
out.
Oh, good. I'm so glad.
Lay it in there, and we'll get a response from Eldon Gibson. The Martian was a big hit at the party because he used his blank as a corkscrew.
Antenna.
Antenna, she said. And the audience is yay, Harry, indicating it's a good answer. Brett?
I don't want anybody else picking on me anymore for the rest of the week. Antenna.
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 I remember her well. Spelling doesn't count. Joni?
I certainly hope not, because I put that down.
You put down antenna. Okay. So you've got all celebrities matched up, Evelyn, and you know what you've got to do when we get to you next, but first we've got to get to this. Okay. Hello there. Got to say goodbye to you, but you're going to join us next time, right? And we'll pick it up right at this very point in the middle of round two. And I'm sorry to say, we've got to say goodbye to you, too. But as usual, you were all splendid. And we'll look forward to seeing your bodies on this very stage next time we get together. This is Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74.